Good morning, Davidson. It's your boy, Andrew Snowberger.
It's your man Hollis Bowden.
And today is Tuesday, March 9th, 2021.
Now let's pass to Galen Green Apple for the weather. I got that. I'm terrible at catching things. Free food. Today we'll have high of sunny, low 41, 5% chance of rain. And tomorrow we'll have high of 76, low 48, and a 5% chance of rain. Back to you, Hollis. Free food. And now, please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may now be seated.
This is a friendly reminder that the applications for the National Honor Society for Dance must be submitted by this Thursday, March 11th. There we go.
There is now Lucky Charm Grams organized by the National Arts Honor Society. These grams include milk chocolate gold coins and slash or a 3x3 mini painted canvas created by the NAHS members. Orders have been accepted since February 23rd and will end on March 29th. The chocolate coins are $2, the miniature painted canvas is $4, and both together are $5.
Sounds fun. Festive. Anyways, please join me in celebrating our newest Teacher of the Week and Staff Member of the Week, Curtis Adams and Jeff Pullum.
Pulliam,
that's what I meant to say.
Anyways, the Helen Rufflin Reading Bowl team plays third in the state. Ooh. Please congratulate the following students for their hard work and dedication to the Reading Bowl. Elizabeth Bearden, team captain, senior. Raven Callahan, who is a senior. Kelsey Schuyler, who is also a senior. Imani Jacobs, who is a junior.
And Lillian Seibert, she's a junior. Ariana Anderson is a sophomore. Taylor Brown, sophomore. Caleb Walters, sophomore. Sorry if I butchered anybody's name.
I'm a sophomore.
You are.
But with that being said, now for a moment in women's history.
Mother Teresa was baptized Agnes Gonja Boyajiu in Skopje, Macedonia around August 26, 1910. Born of Albanian descent, she joined the Loreto Sisters of Dublin, Ireland at the age of 18 and took the name Sister Mary Teresa. In 1931, Mother Teresa traveled to Calcutta, India to teach at an all-girls high school. But on September 10, 1946, a second calling from Christ led Mother Teresa to leave her convent and devote herself to working with the poorest of the poor. With Vatican permission, in 1950, Mother Teresa created the Missionaries of Charity. During the 60s, Mother Teresa opened hospices, orphanages, and leper houses all over India, and later expanded internationally. In 1982, during the Siege of Beirut, Mother Teresa traveled through a war zone to evacuate 37 children, and later assisted radiation victims at Chernobyl and earthquake victims in Armenia. In 1979, Mother Teresa was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize and donated the $192,000 prize fund to the poor in India. 6 years later, President Ronald Reagan awarded her with a Presidential Medal of Freedom. By 1986, Mother Teresa operated 517 missions in more than 100 countries. After years of suffering from heart, lung, and kidney problems, Mother Teresa died on September 5, 1997. 2 years later, Pope John Paul II opened a formal process toward beatification to make Mother Teresa an official Catholic saint.
Now, let's pass to Andy and Karishma for Word of the Day.
Ooh!
Hi, I'm Annie.
And I'm Karishma.
And we always do that hand motion, just like that one.
Yeah.
Who's making noise over there?
What is that? I thought we clearly said quiet on. Hold on. This word is event.
It means to reveal a quality or a feeling.
So like a book could lead up and event something.
Like all of your crappy romance novels do.
Why is it always coming back to my crappy romance novels?
Because they're crappy in romance novels. They're like Hallmark movies
in a book. Did you know they're making Hallmark movies into books?
Heh. Mawkish. There we go.
Mawkish. Saccharine. Mawkish. Okay. Anyway, we're gonna stop now.
Yeah.
That's all for today. Bye!
As always, a very wordtacious word today.
Mm-hmm.
Lunch will be chicken nuggets with mac and cheese, peanut butter and jelly sandwich, green greens, and rosy applesauce. And milk. I wonder what makes the applesauce so rosy.
Strawberries,
that's it. There we go.
This is National School Breakfast Week. And today we're scoring big with a healthy breakfast that isn't just for athletes. School breakfast helps everyone succeed. Enjoy your morning meal and then go gold and have a fantastic day. Indulge in the new Crunch Time Breakfast Bar tomorrow. And also remember to dress up to celebrate Spirit Day and submit your activity sheets to the nutrition staff for the chance to win an awesome giveaway prize. Also, don't forget on March 10th, we will have a faculty and staff best dress competition. Send your best dress photos by 5 p.m. on March the 10th to Patricia Fisher at fishpa@boe.richmond and all that other good stuff you see at the bottom of your screen. Don't forget to submit.
Oh, and we have a birthday!
We got a birthday!
Let us wish Connor Melcher a happy birthday.
And with that, can you continue singing, please?
Just go ahead.
Okay. If you or any of your friends have birthdays coming up, email name and picture to wdfamorningshow@gmail.com, and we will announce it on the show.
Well, I hate to say it, but that's all we have for this fine Tuesday morning. But for closure, remember that never give up on things that make you smile. I'll never give up on you, Andrew.
You bet I make you smile?
Yes, you make me smile, Andrew.
Happy smile or like, oh my God, I have to deal with him smile?
A little bit of both. We will see you later.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow, too.